எஸ்கிவா தெரியும். So happy morning to all. So on behalf of Department of Tripoli Aegis Pillai Engineering College, a warm welcome to everyone. So first of all, I would like to thank our management, our secretary, our beloved principal, and our beloved HOD, Dr. V. Mohan, who is present here, and our chief executive officer, Dr. Chandrasekhar. I welcome you all, and I would like to welcome professors of the Department of Tripoli and other departments also. I welcome you all. So I'd like to welcome all the participants from various engineering colleges, schools, and other institutions. I welcome you all. So I would like to welcome our speaker, Mr. Gopi Krishnan, a second year student of Tripoli. I welcome you, and I welcome our beloved HOD to introduce about the speaker. Thank you.
Very good morning to one and all present here. So it's my great pleasure to introduce our student, a second year student, Mr. Gopi Krishnan of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. Today is going to handle the session on electrical energy conservation and electrical safety for the benefit of school and the college students. I hope all of you will enjoy the session. He has completed a diploma in electrical and electronics engineering, and now he is taking care of two clubs, active member in two different clubs. He has given a lot of lectures in a simulation club, and he is doing a lot of many projects. Even in the second year itself, he is guiding so many batches. So with this brief introduction, now I welcome Gopi Krishnan to present the webinar. Gopi, all the best.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for welcoming me. Once again, I welcome you all participants. Webinar on energy conservation and electrical safety. I would like to thank our college management, CEO sir, principal sir, and sincere thanks to Dr. V. Mohan sir, our HOD of Tripoli, and Dr. T. Suresh Padmanabhan sir, professor Tripoli, for giving this wonderful opportunity to and motivate to do this student webinar series. I hope that you are all interesting and informative from this session. No further delay, we can move to our session. First of all, this session is divided into two parts. One is energy conservation and another one is electrical safety. These all are content we will discuss in this session. But introduction to energy conservation and then star rating. Continuously we will discuss about energy conservation in your home appliance, and then introduction to electrical safety, and then electrical shock, and continuously we will discuss earthing and ELCB, earth leakage circuit breaker, and finally we will discuss electrical fire, do's and don'ts in electrical system. First of all, energy transformation. You know the definition for energy conservation. Energy neither can be created nor be destroyed, can be converted one form to another form. So that electrical energy is the one form of energy. It will convert light energy, sound energy, kinetic energy, whatever may be, like that. Importance of star rating. You are all seeing this star rating in your home appliance. What they are says, color star with color strip, count the star. How many star colored in your home appliance? More star you color, you save more energy. That you save more save electricity. And then know the number of electricity unit per your consumed. Your appliance, how many energy you consumed. For example, 680 is consumed by this appliance. For more rating, 580 is consumed by per year. And then this is certified that BEE is Bureau Energy Efficiency. This logo is appear in this label. This is authority for the label. It will test and give ratings and how much is power the appliance consume, whatever. Maybe the BEE is. First of all, then we will consume energy conservation in your home appliance. First, we will discuss about lightning. Lightning is used in day-to-day our life. So that how will save energy? First, turn off your light before leave from home or leave from your room so that you can conserve your energy. Use natural lights. Most of all, use natural lights. How will install glass windows in your home so that you can consume light from outside. Don't use incandescent lamp because the incandescent lamp efficiency is 90% of heat energy, only 10% of light energy. So that don't use incandescent lamp in your home. Use LEDs. Compared to another lamps, LED is more efficient than other lamps. So that use LEDs, it will more efficiency. Do not use ordinary choke. Because the ordinary choke has it also called ballot choke. It will consist of coils inside the ballot, so that the waste of energy only in coil. So that don't use ordinary chokes. Use electronic choke, better than ordinary choke. Use LED tube lights because of nowadays market available LED tube lights, so that you can install anywhere. So that you use LED tube lights. These all are comparison between incandescent lamp, CFL and LED. LEDs compared to another lamps, 12 watts LED is equal to 60 watts of incandescent lamp. So that you use LEDs most of case. Then for example, the toxic mercury is contained no in incandescent lamp, but CFL contains 1 to 5 gram milligrams of mercury, but no LED contains no. So that these are our comparisons of those three lamps. Energy conservation in your washing machine. You can use to wash the your cloth. You can use washing machine. Always wash your cloth in full load. You can wash your use your washing machine less than cloth unnecessarily, there is waste of energy. It will recover from store your cloth 1 week cloth, then you will wash. Use the amount of detergent water stay because of you may need to use more water to remove the excessive detergent, so that water and electricity waste there. So that use record amount of detergents. Then set time for types of nature of cloth. What will it be? Maybe cotton, maybe nylon. What type of cloth you may test? Set time for that nature of cloth. Use natural drying. If emergency purpose, you only use a machine dryer. Otherwise, use natural drying because of natural drying is available in your all place. So that use natural drying. If emergency purpose, you can use machine dryers. Energy conservation in your air conditioner. Seal the room, check the room fully sealed and closed, enclosed, because of outside air enter into the your room, so that check the rooms are fully closed, enclosed. Clean the filters regularly, because the volume of air does not enter into the your AC, so that the filter is fully dusted, does not air will enter. Set the temperature. BE recommended that 24 degree Celsius for your air conditioner, because that is enough to cool your room. For small room, you use air cooler fans. So it will more efficient, convenient for your small room. Do not use air conditioner for your small rooms. Energy conservation in your refrigerator. Refrigerator mostly used in day-to-day life. How will conserve energy? Clean regularly. You clean regularly your refrigerator. It avoiding odors in your refrigerator, so that you clean regularly your refrigerator. Ensure that your doors are fully closed, like that, tightly enclosed, because of inside cool, out of from your refrigerator, so that ensure that your doors are fully tightly closed. Then label and store it the items, because of where items does not store too long, it also spoil and odors in your refrigerator, so that label that. For example, you name that as Monday, Sunday, Wednesday, Tuesday, whatever may be you use to store. Adjust temperature for your climate change. Adjust temperature for your requirement. You set more amount of temperature, compressor motor will get to cool more, running to cool these items, so that your required amount of temperature will be set. And energy conservation in don't open doors frequently, because of outside air will enter into the your refrigerator, so that the compressor motor is on to run and then cool, compensate the temperature. Don't put hot items into the refrigerator. Before you putting the hot items, the first of all, cool it, and then you will into the refrigerator. And the energy conservation in your computer, your day-to-day life, you are using PC, laptops, whatever. First, adjust brightness of your computer. It will reduce 50% or 30%. That is enough to see your monitors. That is enough. And set sleep time. Sleep time, if you leave from your you not you switch off your computer, you leave from there, but the PC is in on condition, you stay time to 50 minutes, that is enough to segregate that. And then you use your wallpaper background is black, in black, it also may conserve energy. Unplug unwanted peripherals like printers, scanners, whatever peripherals, USB peripherals, unwantedly connected to your PC, that will consume also power. So that unplug it. Energy conservation in your TV and fan. First of all, energy conservation in your TV, television. You purchase, I already say, you purchase star rated TVs. You turn off your TVs, leave from your home, because unnecessarily running, so that you leave from home, don't use off, it will switch off them. And energy conservation in fan, use regulators, like old regulators, does not use this old regulators. Nowadays electronic regulators are available in your market, so that use the electronic regulators to conserve the energies. And then nowadays energy efficient lamps are available in market, that is made up of BLDC motor, but the cost is more than ordinary fan, so that BLDC motor does not energy efficient fans are not used, so that in future it will cost may be reduced. Energy conservation in your heaters, in your winter seasons, you use key heaters, how will conserve energy? Avoid this immersed heaters, because of it is dangerous compared to another heaters. If used safely, convenient to use, because of this immersed regular heaters was not having some control circuits, is directly connected to our power source, so that if you touch the water, it may be shocked. If any fault is occur, it will shock to you, so that avoid this. If used safely, cannot use. Advantage is low cost compared to other. Use storage water heaters. Used to store the water and then heat, you know, and get output from your taps, so that another compared to another, it will more efficient than others. Use solar water heaters. It is a much efficient than another water heaters, because of it does not have electricity. It will only works depend on solar radiation, so that you can use solar water heaters better than another water heaters. Energy conservation in your water pump. Turn off motor at peak hours, because in peak hours the motor have more highly watts, so that don't use peak hours motor, that is conserve your energy. Use water level indicators. You use water level indicator, you can see how much water you store in tank, and also conserve energy, because of fall into water out of from your tank, that will be reduced. Then use water level controller. It is a higher end of water level indicator. This water level controller, you may on in manual mode and as well as auto mode. If you automatically, if water fill full tank, it will turn off your motor, so that don't waste of energy there. And the higher end solar water pumps also you may be use, because your water pump does not depend on your EB supply. You can use solar panels and then get radiation from sunlight, and then use to our submarine motors, and then use energy conservation in your iron box. Iron box also you are maybe used in your day-to-day life. How to save energy in your iron box? First of all, set temperature. What type of cloth, nature of cloth you may be iron. Set the temperature for the nature of cloth, and then you will use it. Most of case you use automatic iron box, because of it heat fully, then it will automatically turn off. The heat will reduce, then automatically turn on, so that may use automatic iron box. Don't use water well ironing. Some people iron well ironing, spray water to iron there, because that is cool the iron box, so that if automatic iron box, it will temperature will rises automatically. So that don't use water well ironing. Don't iron wet cloth, because of if any earth fault in your iron box that touch our metal plate, so that if you iron wet cloth, it will pass through your body, so that you get shock. So that don't use do not iron the wet cloth, that is safe. 8 things to conserve energy in your home appliance. First of all, invest your money in your solar panel. because of solar energy is free energy, so that that you can get energy from sun and then use converted into electricity, solar energy into electrical energy, and we can use, so that invest in your e-people will also reduce, and you may repeat to EB and get money from EB, so that invest solar panels. Unplug appliance, if may unplug your appliance, then the remain power is stored in your battery, so that even night days you can use the power in use gas stoves. Most of case nowadays we are all using gas stove, so now we are you are all aware about that, so that gas stove is efficient than cooking. Replace outside bulb to say with the sensor. How is one person is behind your wall or our doors, the lights are automatically turns on. If you get in or get out, it will automatically turns off. It will be done by sensor. It may be proximity sensor, IR sensor, anywhere is useful to turn off and off your lights. Then I also already told that switching to longer lasting energy efficient LED tube lights, so that you will conserve more energies. And then invest in also I told a solar water heater. It will does not have energy to run that, so that you can use solar water heaters. Then we will discuss about now electrical safety. Electrical safety, so it is dangerous, you know, it is dangerous. The crows are sitting into our live line conductors. You think it is dangerous? Yeah, I will explain now. This is a simple electrical circuit. This is you assume that does not lights are no in there. You assume only this is one conductor, this is one conductor, and this is a crow, like that. This crow is sitting in one conductor. There is no in between the conductor and another conductor, so that no current passing through it. Crow touch another conductor, this circuit open circuit. Maybe the crow touch another conductor, the current will pass through it, so that it is called short circuit. This is will happen there. This electrical shock and electrical shock is a physical reaction to you, to electrical current passing through your body. So maybe your heart also stopped through current through your body. Effect of human body. What will affect your body get shock? You may aware about conductor and insulator, and then how much resistance you body have. Ear to ear have 100 ohm resistance, head to foot you have 500 ohms. Dry skin, if you have dry skin, you have 350,000 ohms, and wet skin have 1,000 ohms only. So that do not touch wet skin in your home appliance. Effect of shock. Cases of 2-volt DC battery, because of DC is direct current, does not changes. If you touch your battery, it will more dangerous, very 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 dangerous, and then damage your skins as well as you will get that, because it will have directly in one direction. There is no
excuse me Mr. Gopi, please increase your volume.
Okay,
there are some feedback from participants. Please increase your volume. Okay, thank you.
Okay sir.
Continue.
If you cases of your 110 volt AC, is better than DC, but it's not dangerous. AC is not dangerous, but DC is very, very dangerous. Does not play with DC. Compared to DC, AC is much better than that is because the AC wave have one positive, one negative. So that you negative, if you occur negative, it will power is reduced. So that careful. What is earthing? Earthing is used to protect your equipment from an electrical shock. It also providing a path to flow of fault current to earth, so that earthing is much important to your home. So that install earthing. There are three types of earthing. One is plate earthing and rod earthing, pipe earthing. Most of case we are using pipe earthing. We will use in home. Another one, if you touch any material like electrically connected any material, you must be earthed it, because if any fault current occurs there, if you touch and then you get shock. So that if any motors, washing machine, refrigerator, anything, you can must be earthed. Connections of plug, you may see in, open and see it, your plug, you can see these connections of plug. First top, there are three pins are available. One is face, another neutral, and then earth. Earth is also you are connected into your equipment. Neutral wire is return path. It's a return path. Live wire is connected through a fuse, because if any high voltage occurs there, it will burn and then break the circuit. So that we will use protection purpose, so that we will use fuse there. Nowadays, we are all get shocked in your house. It will reduced from, it will occur due to short circuit, and then whatever may be fault current, any due to your equipment, this device is installed in your home. Your home gets, if any fault current occurs or earth leakage or return current anywhere, this device is trip the circuit, that is trip supply from your main supply, then your to your home, it will break it, because any fault occurs, it will open. Then what type of problem is occurs, then will recover it. Then electrical fire, the electrical fire due to short circuit, anywhere overload, it will burn and short your circuit. So that fire due to electrical, you does not use water. Some people, it is a fire, so we can use water to blast it. Does not, that is one problem in that. So that don't use water will electrical fire. Use sand. Most of case use sand. This bucket is used in industries. Our home also you can store a sand and then put into our house, nearly our house. It may be recovered from your electrical. Use fire extinguisher. In big house you can use fire extinguisher, because does not to arrest the power, arrest the fire. So that we can use fire extinguisher is much efficient than another sand anywhere. So that use fire extinguisher. Do's and don'ts in your electrical system. First, do's, treat your every electrical device like energy, even if it does not look like plugged or operation, so that treat your electrical devices. Unplug the appliance before performing any service, your service or repair anywhere, so that you are before unplug and then you answer repair it. When you are working electrical device, only use tools that is officially non-conducting handle, that is, for example, screwdrivers, testers, cutters, insulator cutters may be used, so that it will distance between electrical and your hand. Try to limit the use of electrical equipment in small rooms, away very cold rooms, and lot of condensation, because there is no emission of your heat, so that do not use in condensation room. When handling electrical equipment, make sure your hands are dry. Don't touch the electrical equipment with the wet can. Only you touch the equipment with dry hands, so that you may save. Spill any kind of liquid on your electrical equipment, first immediately shut down off. Then main or circuit breaker. Then unplug the equipment. It's safe, because of if any kind of water inside the, your equipment, it may be affect your power supply. Keep all electrical circuit contact point enclosed, because of some loose connection, cutting of some wires. Maybe finally, if you are all able to work in electrical equipment with one hand, well, another hand is out of way of your side pocket, because the minimum change of current passing through your chest should spark an accident charge occurs. Don't. First and foremost, don't touch actively electrical equipment. I beforely say that don't touch in a registry equipment like inactive condition. Never touch electrical equipment when you are part of your body wet, that is include amount of persons, like I already say that wet hand, do not touch your equipment, electrical equipments. Don't store liquid store near the electrical equipment, because if you fall it, then it will enter into your equipment and then get shocked. So that don't store the water is near your electrical equipment. If person comes into contact with the energized electrical conductor, do not touch your equipment. It is could other person affect because the change may be passed to you down on the main power source via circuit breaker, and then unplug equipment using a leather belt, maybe non-conducting material like plastic, leather, anywhere you can use, and then you can touch. Do not wear metal of any sort of working. If you're wearing metal materials, it will get easily shocked to you. So that don't wearing metal equipments during electrical work. Also, don't try to poke and probe, fix electrical equipment with the object like pencil, rulers, because of metal. There are metal conduct. So that several form of conductor. There are form of conductor. So that you can get shock. You prevent that, you will use. Thank you for joining.
Thank you, Gopi.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Nice presentation. Very good informative session. Any questions from audience? I'm looking for the chat box. There is a question from Mr. Kaushik. Mr. Gopi, there is a question from Kaushik.
Yes, sir.
Automatic choke and ordinary choke, which consume less power?
Fine, sir.
Actually, today, nowadays, the automatic choke is coming. What is the function of it?
Inside, you have a H-bridge concept inside the automatic choke. It will more efficient than ordinary choke, so that you can use electronic choke better than ordinary choke.
Okay, so then any other question regarding a feedback link that will be posted in the chat box, as well as it will be sent to your email ID. You may fill it up, and the automatic generation of the e-certificate will be filled today. So the link will be sent to you today. Please fill it up. Maybe after this completion of this session, you will be getting a mail from Webinar Jab. It will be having the link to generate the e-certificate that consists of some questions related to the feedback. So all participants are requested to fill the feedback link to generate the e-certificate automatically.
Professor, actually the feedback link is posted in the chat.
Yes. Dr. V. Mohan, Chaudhary sir actually gave the feedback link in the chat box. Participants are requested to fill the same and get the certificate. And is there any other questions from? Yes. Mr. Nagarajan Selvam, you ask question now. Unmute yourself and ask question. Mr. Nagarajan Selvam. Mr. Selva K. So now you can ask your question now. Mr. Selva, you can unmute yourself and ask question. Some of them raise their hands, but they are not asking the questions. Ashwini Ashok, can you ask question now? Indyal Singh. Okay, then I have some questions for you, Mr. Kopi.
Yes, sir.
So in your presentation, you have told that there is a thing related to the CFL, and for the same watt consumption, which one is preferred, whether it is LED or CFL? Maybe 20 watt LED and 20 watt CFL. Which one is preferred most?
Mostly preferred, LED is mostly preferred, sir, because life is long and you can repair and recycle it. But you can use CFL, does not repair and reuse. So that you can mostly prefer LEDs.
Maybe an engineer can reuse it. So ordinary people, they are unable to reuse it, right? Maybe they can submit it to the vendor and they can get the refill, like your pens or some of the things, right? So the refill something.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, okay. Good. Thank you. And related to the earthing, do you have any idea about the earth resistance? Maybe how much resistance has to be there for a good earthing? How much ohms? Is it possible to measure it?
Yes, sir. One equipment available. Megger is used to measure, and then you that is standard resistance already.
So we can use the earth tester also, right?
Megger.
Earth.
Yes, sir. Megger and earth tester used to measure it.
Okay. 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 How can we identify that? Maybe in a plug. You know, 3-pin plug, which one is phase, which one is neutral, which one is earth?
That does not matter, sir, because AC is alternatingly changes. Because in three pin plug, they have fixed correctly, but two pin plug, there is no problem because AC is have polarities, positive and negative. In AC system, there is no problems occurs.
Okay, good, good. One participant told that the chat box got deleted, so resend the feedback link again. No problem, not an issue. It is already sent. But if you miss this, you can check the mailbox, maybe in the spam folder also, whether it is having any mail from Webinar Jam related to the Aegis Play College of Engineering. It will be having a feedback link. Fill it up and get the e-certificate today itself. Okay, that will not be generated tomorrow. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. Thank you, Guruji.
Thank you,
once again, I would like to thank everyone. The participants from various engineering colleges from Visakhapatnam, Nagpur, Nashik, Kolkata. Today we are very much delighted to have participants from Belgavi, that is in Karnataka. Great. Thank you. And we are student webinar series. We expect the same for the upcoming student webinar series also. Maybe next week we'll be having the third one in different topic that is not related to the core, maybe related to the placement and interpersonal. I would like to thank our management, our beloved secretary, Dr. Chevalier Parameswaran sir, and our CEO, Dr. S. Chandrasekhar, our beloved principal, Dr. S. Ramabalan. With this juncture, we would like to thank everyone. Thank you, sirs. And also, we'd like to thank our beloved HOD, enthusiastic and dynamic HOD, Dr. V. Mogan. Without him, this was not possible. So, thank you very much, sir. And I also would like to thank our guest of honor, that is speaker, Mr. Gopi. Really, in a second year, from among the 60 number of students, you came across some events and we have a great session today. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Gopi. And once again, we'll meet in the next event. Thank you very much. Thank you.